In this final video on pathways of carbohydrate metabolism, I'll give an overview of the pentose phosphate pathway, which is represented on this master diagram in a simplified form. A slightly better representation is here. You can think of the pentose phosphate pathway as having two major variations. A key point is that in both variations, electrons are transferred from carbon to NAD+ to make NADPH. Recall that NADPH is an electron carrier that usually provides electrons to biosynthetic pathways. So in this sense, the pentose phosphate pathway can be thought of as promoting biosynthesis. The two variations of the pathway differ in terms of what happens to the carbon atoms that are not oxidized to make NADPH. The remaining carbons either go to glycolysis and are oxidized to pyruvate, or they're used to make ribose 5-phosphate, which is good for synthesizing nucleotides. Let's look at each of these options in turn. Under conditions when the cell needs NADPH but also needs to continue to produce ATP, some glucose 6-phosphate is diverted from glycolysis so that carbon can be oxidized to carbon dioxide. Electrons are taken from carbon and put onto NADP+ to make NADPH. But not all carbons are oxidized in this way. Most of the carbons are converted to intermediates in glycolysis so that they can re-enter glycolysis and be converted to pyruvate, a process that produces ATP. This is one version of the pentose phosphate pathway. The net reaction of this version of the pentose phosphate pathway is shown here. For every 3 glucose 6-phosphate molecules that enter the pathway, 3 carbons are oxidized to carbon dioxide, producing 6 NADPH molecules. The CO2 is a waste product and is exhaled. The NADPH molecules are a source of electrons for reduction reactions in biosynthetic processes. The other 15 carbon atoms from the original 3 G6P molecules end up as either fructose 6-phosphate or glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which are intermediates in glycolysis. These molecules proceed through glycolysis to make pyruvate, NADH, and ATP. For the test, you are not responsible for memorizing this net reaction. The other version of the pentose phosphate pathway occurs when the cell prioritizes nucleotide synthesis. As in the first version, some carbon is oxidized to CO2 to produce NADPH. However, the remaining carbons do not go back into glycolysis, but are converted to ribose 5-phosphate. Thus, the major products of this version of the pentose phosphate pathway are NADPH and ribose 5-phosphate. Ribose 5-phosphate is the monosaccharide that is the basis for nucleotides. In the net reaction of this version of the pentose phosphate pathway, one carbon is oxidized to carbon dioxide for every glucose 6-phosphate molecule that enters the pathway, producing 2 NADPH molecules. The other 5 carbon atoms from the G6P molecule become ribose 5-phosphate, which is used for nucleotide synthesis. No carbons return to glycolysis, and no ATP is made. Again, you are not responsible for memorizing this net reaction for the test. I've presented 2 variants of the pentose phosphate pathway. When NADPH is needed, cells will not necessarily pick one or the other to perform exclusively. A mixture of the two pathways is more likely, with one or the other favored depending on conditions, but both happening to some degree. This video concludes the series on carbohydrate metabolism. Next, I'll continue by looking at how pyruvate from glycolysis is oxidized further in mitochondria.